Hello my dear friends. Well, one of the very first important thing that we need to have before we go for a cross-country flying is to have the weather briefing. Unfortunately, many people just ignore it. Many of the student pilots or aviators just ignore it, thinking that they can out-challenge the weather. Unfortunately, some of the pilots are not that lucky enough and they meet an unfortunate end. So here I take another NTSB Aviation Accident Report, which details, which highlights the fact that it is important to have an weather briefing. It is important to have weather briefing before we go for a cross-country flying. So the aircraft in this case was Cessna 172 and the pilot decided to go on a cross country without having a weather briefing. He did not have the weather briefing, and soon after takeoff he ran into bad weather. He saw that the bad weather was coming in and he requested the air traffic controller to fly below 500 feet above the ground level along the ocean shoreline. Ultimately, the controller approved the request and advised that there is heavy precipitation ahead of the aircraft, just 12 o'clock position ahead of the airplane, and it is 4 miles ahead. He also warned that there is severe thunderstorm. The controller also advised the pilot that he should take left turn and should fly offshore 3 miles to avoid the thunderstorm. Now the pilot listened to the advice and acknowledged it, but a review of the GPS and weather radar shows that the flight continued on the same course. There was no deviation made, no changes made according to the instruction given by the controller. So after three minutes later, he reported that he was reversing the direction and no further communication was received from the pilot after that. Now after that, the GPS track of the airplane was reviewed and overlaid on the weather radar plots, and it was found that the airplane flew right into the extreme intensity precipitation and then it started descending, and ultimately it hit the ocean near Hollywood, Florida. Unfortunately, both the people on the boat, the 172, lost their life. Now the wreckage was examined and it did not reveal any evidence of pre-impact mechanical malfunction. There was no mechanical malfunction in the airplane before it hit the ocean. So it was quite probable that the pilot lost control of the aircraft as it flew into strong downdrafts and heavy rain that were associated with the thunderstorm. So my dear friends, what was the probable cause of the aircraft accident? For this aircraft accident, one was that the pilot did not had adequate weather flight briefing. He was not prepared well in advance of what weather he will be encountering ahead of him, and which resulted in continued flight into the thunderstorm. Because of this reason, he continued his flight into the thunderstorm knowingly or unknowingly, and ultimately it led to a loss of control of the aircraft. So my dear friends, before you push on the throttle of the aircraft, make sure that you have your weather briefing with you and you have planned according to that. So the NTSB identification for this is ERA16FA309. My dear friends, make sure that you have weather flight briefing before you take off. Bye for now, and I will come back soon with another video on NTSB accident report. Bye, happy landings.